Hello and welcome to today's the day number 7. 007. Powerful. Today's the day 007 with me, Julie South. The agenda for today's podcast is the review of the podcast I listened to while I was out walking, which is Russell Brunson's Marketing Secrets, episode dated 25th of July 2017. Life According to Julie. How legit are you? This thought came to me after I listened to Russell's podcast. And what I've done is, he talked about legit, and I'll get into that. I've created 7 characteristics of legit leadership. Then we go into attitude of gratitude today, my day today in pictures. Then is last on the agenda, Business Bites, referral marketing, 6 numbers that you need to know to grow your business. The podcast is, as I said earlier, it's podcast review. This is Marketing Secrets, episode dated the 15th of July 2017, where Russell interviewed Dr. Matt Accurso. Dr. Matt's calling is to transform average human potential into extraordinary human performance. And he's on a mission to catapult individuals into their most fulfilling life potential imaginable. That's the summary of Dr. Matt, who Russell Brunson interviewed today. What I got out of that is legit. Are you legit? By that, they have called legit as another word for being authentic. I really am not one of these people who, I think the word authentic and authenticity has been banded around so much that it's actually lost its meaning and its power. It's become hackneyed. But what I want to do is talk about 7 characteristics. This is Life According to Julie. 7 characteristics of legitimate leadership. By legitimate, I mean that you are being truly yourself. You're being true to you and you're being powerful because you're being true to you. So let's look at them. Number 1 is self-awareness and the development of your personal strengths. Do what you are good at and allow others, encourage others on your team, in your life, to focus on their strengths as well. So self-awareness and further development of your personal strengths. Number 2, in line with that, is know your weaknesses and your limitations. Round pegs for round holes. If you're not good at something, if it bores you stupid, delegate it, because you're not being your best self. You're not being true to yourself. You're not being legit. So number 2, know your weaknesses and limitations. Number 3 is make all of your decisions based on your values. So your values rule your life and your values govern the decisions that you make. To thine own self be true. If you make a decision and you have a gut feeling that this is not right for you, believe me, it will come back and bite you. Bigger the value that is being compromised, the harder the bite. Number 4, integrity. Integrity to me is like being pregnant. It's impossible to be partly or almost pregnant. You either are or you're not. You either have integrity or you don't. And you only have integrity until that point where you stuff up. And then you've got to reclaim that, make good, move forward. So integrity. It's black and white. It's not a gray thing. Integrity is every every single moment, every single decision you make. And that could be, for example, if you say that you are going to be home in time to have dinner with your family, and you're not, you've just broken your integrity. Your integrity has been compromised. If you say you're going to watch your kids play sport, do it. If you say you're going to be on time at, you know, you've got a meeting at a certain time, you've got an appointment with a client at a certain time, be on time. Because the moment you're not is when you've broken your integrity. Number five, legitimate leaders have empathy and respect. They are empathetic and respectful of others. They can imagine what it's like to walk in somebody else's shoes, and they respect. I guess it's a bit like, you know, an example of this could be that I just said, used just now, with being on time. You're respectful of others' time. So legit leaders are empathetic and respectful of others. They are courageous. It means making the tough decisions and living by them. Sometimes you just gotta do it. You just gotta make those tough decisions. And it takes guts to make those tough decisions. Leaders who hide behind people aren't leaders. They're followers. Leaders don't blame. You know, leaders are able to put their hands up and say, yes, I screwed up. Let's get on with it from here. How can we make it better? Leaders are also, number seven, emotionally mature. It means that they express their emotions in appropriate ways. They don't have hissy fits and act like two-year-olds when they don't get their way. Doesn't mean to say that they don't cry, that they don't get angry, that they don't get upset. But they are mature with the expression of those emotions. And that takes courage. So that was Life According to Julie. Looking at my day in pictures today, we have... I took a bit of a different route this morning. I love ducks. I saw a couple of ducks. But I noticed that the current was so strong that they were almost marking time against, because they were, you know, paddling against the current. And I wonder how many times we feel like we're not getting anywhere because we're going against the current, when all we have to do is just go with the flow and life flows much easier. I saw a riverboat today that I have not seen ever before. I have no idea. I think it might be the River Queen, but I'm not sure. First time I've seen it on the Waikato River, so I took some photos of that. We've had a lot of rain. This photo here looks like a river. It's actually a pathway. Now, I always wondered this. In spring, when daffodils grow in the middle of a field of grass, how do the people that mow the lawns know not to mow the daffodils over? This is a planting of daffodils that a few of them are out already, and it's going to be good when they're all out. But how do the lawn mowers know not to mow over the daffodil bulbs when they're still sprouting, so that they continue to sprout? Today I walked over a bridge. Because I am not blessed with Julia Roberts' legs, I tried to get this photograph. This bridge has this beautiful, bubbling, gurgling stream that flows underneath it. And I tried to get a photograph of the stream, but I had to lean so far over, and I'm not tall enough to lean so far over, that, yes, you didn't actually get the stream. Did lots of uphill walking there. You can see how I'm sweating. That's my day in pictures today. What I want to talk about now, today's business bite, is referral marketing. And this is six numbers that I believe you need to know. The first one, number one, referees, people referred, are four times more likely to buy when referred by a friend. Four times. You need a referral marketing program in your business because these numbers are important. When you have your clients acting as brand ambassadors for you, the lifetime value for new referral customers is 16% higher than customers who are not referred. 16%. That's huge. 92% of people trust referrals from people they know. 31% of business owners track that social media traffic leads to their website. That's what you want as a business owner. You want everything online leading to your website. 83% of consumers are willing to refer after a positive experience, yet only 29% of them actually do. This is where you need a referral marketing program. Look at all of those who 83% of people want to refer, but only 29% of them do. They probably forget, you know, they know they mean to. They mean to get around to it, but they never do. So you're missing almost, 71% of the 83%. That's huge. How much more business could you have if you picked up that extra 73%, 71%? When businesses have a referral marketing program in place and it's managed, they achieve revenue goals three times those who don't have a managed referral marketing system in their business. Three times. You could be three times better than you are if you manage your referral marketing program. This is Julie South helping real estate agents get found, get seen, and get more listings. How to get in touch with me, julie@halobiz.co.nz. If you are listening to this podcast, go to highprofilerealtor.com and the show notes are there with the pictures if you're interested and the slides and the stats. Go out there and be awesome and have a fantastic day.